someday maybe we'll understand how knowledge is represented in the human brain. You know, it's one of the great mysteries of how evolution did that. Do you think in the end we'll find it, let's say we figure out both the software and the real brain, do you think we'll end up seeing that there are similar algorithms underlying how they work?
Oh, good question. what do you think?
Well, you know, I think there are aspects like visual recognition where we can see that as you go up and you're kind of trying to go to higher level representations, that some of the same mistakes that the human visual system makes weirdly appear in these systems. So that at least suggests that there's a common way. And, you know, evolution, you know, was sort of trying out different approaches. And so it may be that there's this one fundamental approach that we see a glimpse of in software that, you know, evolution, quote, discovered, quote, and managed to use. I mean, it's the greatest miracle, the human's reasoning capability is so phenomenal.
Yeah, totally. So, yeah, like the evolution somehow figured out the algorithm behind our amazing learning capabilities, but we humans haven't figured out the AI version of it yet. I suspect that there's a definitely better algorithm out there that we haven't discovered. It's just right now, there's a bit too much focus on let's make things larger, and everybody's trying to do that. Whereas there may be really better solution, alternative solution that's waiting to be found, but there's just not enough of an attention there because people tend to think, oh, it's not going to work. The reason why I very strongly believe that is in part because when you look at, let's go back to Microsoft in the very first personal computer, because when that first came out, it was really super exciting and amazing. And then every single year, you know, there's a better computer and smaller computer, faster computer, and it becomes better and better. So similarly, when we look at phones or, you know, rockets, cars, the very first invention is never the optimal solution. There's always a better solution. So I do think that there's a better solution. It's just that right now there's way too much emphasis on the bigger, the better.
I do think, like in the math tutor case, though, the downside of a mistake can be pretty modest. Yeah. And I think we are seeing that we should be able, give us 2 or 3 years, to create something there that is pretty profound for engaging learners in a way that's motivating and at the right level for them. So that'll be a pioneering test that, you know, is not the same as relying on it for dangerous decisions.
Yeah, I totally agree.
Are you worried that things could go too fast, you know, and almost have humans even ignore the control and the misuse? You know, the sense of purpose of humans, if we're sort of dumb compared to the AI, that I'm more worried about that now than I was a few years ago.
Even I get a bit of an uneasy feeling if hypothetically, suddenly AGI does arrive and it's just all around better than us. How are we supposed to think about that? Like, are they going to find, replace all of us and we just go vacation all the time? That sounds really boring. So although that thought experiment is quite interesting, even if that doesn't happen, still, I worry that AI is impacting human life a lot already, and it will do so even more in the coming years. It seems that unless we put right kind of efforts trying to understand where the limitations and capabilities are and then try to develop both policy but also other AI techniques that can better control this impact on humans, I think this could be, if we don't put enough effort, so this could be disastrous. So if we're not ready for it, it could be very hard on us. So I'm hoping that, I'm at least optimistic that more and more people worry about this, and then there's a lot more conversation going on. So I hope that that it's a sign of people doing more actions around it. But yeah, it's a concern.
Subscribe to Unconfuse Me wherever you listen to podcasts.